Paul Weller formed the Style Council in 1983, he wanted to get away from the punk guitar sound of his previous band, The Jam. Together with Mick Talbot, they wanted to try a fresh approach with a larger lineup and a broader musical stance, embracing the new technology available to them. But is Paul Weller now tempted to recreate the rawer sound of The Jam with the Style Council, given the current crop of successful guitar-based bands?
No, I can't stand that sort of music anymore. I never liked it very much in the first place, you know, even though The Jam were lumped in with that, or have been, I never saw them that way at all. I've always hated those guitar bands. But, I don't know, I don't necessarily agree about the technology, because a lot of the records that are making it now, a lot of the soul things are just quite simple, really. They're back to basics, piano. You know, in fact, there's not real drums. I mean, some of the records are real drums, others are drum machines, but the patterns are quite simple and it's quite straightforward, I think. It's good. That's what's, you know, to me, it's what's positive about it. You know, you can actually go out and play that stuff live and anyone can make that sort of music, or at least it makes you feel that way. You haven't got to be as clever as Jam and Lewis.
Style Council single is a version of Joe Smooth's Promised Land, a dance floor hit with a gospel feel, which was first noticeable in the band's music as far back as Walls Come Tumbling Down. So is this gospel feel intentional?
We kind of hear that the original song is a gospel song anyway, and we just try to bring out more of that element, you know, or put more of that element into the song, or whatever way you look at it.
But how can gospel music still relate to life in the 80s?
The style they call inspirational, which isn't always necessarily related to Christianity or religion or whatever, but just kind of trying to inspire people in a positive way, which, you know, I mean, I think some of our own songs have kind of worked in that way as well, not stylistically, but, you know, the kind of principle behind it. So it's just a question of, you know, being positive about it, you know, looking to a better time for the world or for people.
So what new music are the Style Council listening to at the moment?
I think it's a really good time for music at the moment, and there's been flight in the last sort of year or so, and hopefully better things to come. But I think you know, there's a lot of things, good things that come out of Chicago and Detroit and New York especially. But Ted City I really like, and a group called Blazer from New Jersey, they're really good. But, you know, for me, anything that's got a good feel to it or got a nice tune, you know, I don't know. Soul records in the charts, and some of them are real underground sounds as well, stuff which would never have made it 18 months ago.
One of Paul Weller's original aims in performing the Style Council was to avoid the established album tour routine which The Jam had got into. So has this band managed to do things its own way?
I don't know, it's difficult to avoid that in some ways, I think. I mean, I sort of often think, would I be good at something else? But I don't know if I would be. There's not too many things that interest me, really. And at the same time, it's quite frightening to think that, you know, all I can ever do is make records or make music. I don't know. I'm stuck with it, really. Well, I don't think about it too much anymore. Just get on with it.